what's in the Word of God. Amen? So if you have your Bibles, let's look at Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 6 and 7. That is in the Old Testament. Prophet Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 6 through 7. Also, we're going to turn to the New Testament in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 11. Again, I say Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 6 through 7. And then 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 11. It is also on the monitors for your reading as well. Follow the Word of God. And we'll be using the KJV version. And I also sometimes will go to the NLT, which is the New English Translation as well. And the Word of the Lord reads, if you have it, it says, "Then said I, our Lord God, behold, I cannot speak, for I am a child. But the Lord said unto me," notice, "say not, I am a child. Thou shalt go to all that I shall send thee, and whatsoever I command thee, thou shalt speak." Let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 11. Notice what the Bible says. "When I was a child, I spake as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child." Amen. "But when I became a man, I put away childish things. For now we see through a glass darkly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then shall I know even as I am known." I want to talk to you and to the young people tonight. I'm sure the older would be able to get something out of this as well. I believe the whole church will be able to get something from this. "When I was a child." My title is, "When I was a child." Amen. Let us all stand. Brother Aiden, I want you to stand up, sir. We're going to stand and reverence the Lord. We're going to pray and ask God to help us. In Jesus' name, let us pray. Father God, we love you, we thank you, for we have read the Word of God. Lord God, right now, I pray, speak to us right now. Let our hearts be open to receive. Father, we thank you for the saints making their way back here to the house of the Lord. God, what you're showing and what you allow me to see, you already know that these saints that are, Lord, been born again. God, I notice that they're coming to the house of the Lord faithfully. So I ask that you will bless her. I ask that you will bless her family. I ask that you will bless him and bless his family. Help us to all grow. We are all children of God. God, I pray in the name of Jesus that we will grow in maturity in the name of the Lord to be a help in the kingdom of God. Will you bless us tonight? Lord, bring things back to my memories. Help me say it the way that you want me to say it, that it ain't understanding. Father, it's not of me. I never walk around with a big head because I know it is Christ that lives inside of me. So that, Lord, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. Help me to help your people. Help me that I can walk them right before them and be an example. Father, I love them, but I know you love them more. So keep your hands upon us right now, for we forever remember all that you have done and that you're going to do. So we give you glory, honor in the name of Jesus. Wake us up. Help us to understand as children to receive in the name of Jesus Christ. We give you glory, honor, and praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Clap your hands, everybody, in Jesus' name as you're being seated. Hallelujah. When I was a child. When I was a child. I have a mindset that even though I'm a little bit older, maybe younger than some and older than others, my mind is set that I feel in my mind that I can still do some of the same things when I was 19. But it's captured in my mind. Because if I try to do that with my body, there's some things that will not happen the way I want it to. That's why young people, they can get up and go, don't need a lot of this and that. But I'm noticing myself that now when I bend or when I do certain things, I come up just a little bit slower. I move a little bit slower. Amen. And so I remember loving being in the gym and pushing the weights and challenging people for my size, my stature, of how much I could push and do all of this. But now, if I were to try to do that, I would be in bed for days because of hurting and pain and aches. And so, this will happen to you young people as you get older. I'm telling you right now, the youth that you have, and some of the older will say, don't get me wrong, they stay fit, they stay jogging, they do these things, you walk, you check your pulse, and you do all of these things. That's all good. But I don't care what you say, Father Time will catch up with you, and you will not be the child anymore. Amen. You can smile at that in Jesus' name. So that's why people will call you mother or elder. Amen to that. Hallelujah. And so I thank God for that. And so as we grow older, we are not what we were. And so even in the spiritual, I remember being a new babe in Christ. I remember. So that's why sometimes when people will say, well, you might look at somebody and maybe their age might be younger than yours, but spiritually they can be older than you. Anybody understand what I'm saying? That you can look at somebody and say, well, that young man is younger than me. That's good. I am. Thank God for the younger age. But at the same time, spiritually, they can be older than you, which means they have walked with the Lord and the Lord has been in their life or the head of their life for quite some time. God has shown them revelational things. They've been sitting under some training where they've gotten wisdom and understanding and knowledge of the Word of God, where that wisdom comes from the Word of God and led by the Holy Ghost. So spiritually, they can be older than you. And so it doesn't mean that they feel like they're better than you, or they feel like they can tell you about yourself or anything like that, or maybe whoop you or do anything like that. But no, spiritually, I understand you've been walking with the Lord quite longer than I have. That would be like Bishop Davey or my pastor. I understand that they have dealt with many things that I have not dealt with yet. I understand that he has a church over 2,000. I'm only dealing with about 100 and something right now, 150, 160, sometimes 170. With that being said, I thank God for my pastor because he is an example of what I'm trying to get to. So many times I would call him and I would say, Bishop, or I'll call pastor, can you give me some feedback regarding this? I need some counsel. I need some understanding. I need you to talk to me about this matter. How do I handle this? Or how did you handle this situation? And so it is good to dwell around those who can give you counsel, who kind of know a little bit more than you. That's how you're able to grow, when you're around those who know just a little bit more than you. That's why I say it's always good for you to mentor somebody and for you to have peers as well, but you to also to have a mentee, somebody that is over you. And with that being said, if you need somebody to be able to kind of watch over you, to direct you, to help you while you're helping somebody else, that's always good to be able to grow in God that way. But I just remember, I'm not too grown or old like that. I still feel like I'm a child of the Lord. I got a lot of long way to go, and I got a lot to learn. But I remember when I was a child. I remember when I was a child. Today, when I think about babes in Christ, notice what I said, babes in Christ. I look at babes in Christ like this. That there is a baby that is reading the Word of God, but really may not have understanding or know what they're reading. But they're still precious. Huh? Our teens, our young people, our people that have just got saved, you're still precious to me. Because I understand you are a babe in Christ. So to my young ladies, this is how I would look at you. To those who are sisters that just got saved, you are precious and you are a baby in Christ. You need somebody to teach you, someone to feed you, someone to help you, someone to be there, someone to guide you, someone to keep you out of trouble, someone to keep you from doing things that are wrong that maybe you do not know. So as that, I'm saying, there's a babe in Christ. Is there any more that you have there, sir? Keep going with that. And so with that being said, as babes in Christ, you might pick up the Bible, even in church, you're trying to read it, trying to gain understanding. And this is how it may be. Babes in Christ, they like maybe like coming to church. They may like doing this. And so this is how I'm looking at those. This is how Bishop looked at me. I was a babe in Christ. So there is things that he was not allowing me to get involved in or kept me from, so I wouldn't hurt myself spiritually. Anybody like that? Even in the natural, there's things that my mom would just tell me, do this or do that. And I say, why? Because she said, I told you so. Anybody ever heard those words before? Because I told you so. Well, why are you telling me that? Because I told you so. And so I got tired of hearing that, because I told you so. Just like times I got tired of hearing Bishop saying, well, son, we're going to do this and we're not going to do that. No way. Why you keep saying that, Bishop? Because that's what he meant. Some things he can explain to me, some stuff that he could not explain to me because I wouldn't understand at all anyway. But I thank God for a man that taught me as a son in the gospel and began to teach me the word of God when I was a babe in Christ. So this is how I look. But I'm going to show you how I was when I was in church growing up. This is how I was growing up in church. If you have those pictures for me, sir. I was in church. I was just like this little boy right here. Notice what the scripture says. When church is over and you are trying to leave, but your mama keeps talking. That's how I was. Was you like that? No, you don't. Okay. This is how I was. Ready to go. So no babes, young people, I understand. When you like sitting here, you're bored. You're sitting in the back of the church. You're biting your nails. You might be going through your phone when you should not be going. You got little candy in your purse. When I told you not to go down to the Family Dollar and don't bring that into church, when I'm finding stuff up under the pew, gum and all of that stuff, I know that you're being disobedient and somebody could smack your hand like my mama used to do me. At the same time, this is how I was. I remember, oh God, she's talking again. Can we leave? Man, how many people do she got to talk to? Can you please? And I would try to come and grab her purse. Hey, mama, I'll grab that for you. You know how you try to grab the things that lead towards the door so you can hurry to kind of push them out so we can get ready to get home. Ain't nothing that I really got to do. Maybe watch some cartoons and eat some food and just sit there at home in the air conditioner, play some video games. I had Atari and ColecoVision. Y'all don't know nothing about that. But in today, they know other stuff. But I said I was ready to get home and get out of church. This is how I was looking. Notice how he's holding on his little jacket or his little vest. He said, but mom keeps talking. This is how I was as a babe in Christ. Notice the next picture. This is exactly how many of them are today. Come to church, knocked out. And not even some of the young people, but I'm talking about the older ones. You're still a babe in Christ. Babes in Christ cannot sit through a service, the whole service. At some point, they doze off. At some point, the babes in Christ will doze off. In my church, when we dozed off, you heard somebody grab an ear and twist it to make you wake up, or they'll pinch you somewhere to make your eyes just pop open. You're looking around like, who just stabbed me? Who just did this? Who just did that? But this is what happens to the babes in Christ. We have those mothers that are sitting somewhere over here or over there, and they look at their child from a distance, and you know the look. Anybody ever got the look before? That look was stop talking and wake up. These are for the babes in Christ. And this was another one right here. And as you grow older, as you get older in the Lord, I thank God for all that is done. Because now that I'm older, I'm loving this God that I was taught about. Amen. Out of all that she have done, all that they have taught me, I love this Lord. I love the Lord Jesus. I love God. And I thank God for raising me in the house of the Lord. Amen. I remember giving excuses of saying why I couldn't come back to church. I remember telling the pastor or telling the preacher or the leader, saying, well, I might try to make it new, even though I knew in my mind I wasn't coming back. And this is how I was, a babe in Christ, doing everything I could to maybe visit church every once in a while, or maybe when something has happened, maybe when I'm feeling lonely, or maybe when I'm feeling upset, maybe when I think, God, I need God to bless me, maybe if I lose my job, I need a little money, then it gets me back into church when I'm right before God. That's what happens. So sometimes God got to allow things to happen to draw you back into the church, babes in Christ. But for those that are fully grown, we understand we can do nothing without God. We understand we're not giving God no excuses. We understand we ran out of excuses. We did all of these things. So my mind said, Lord, when the doors are open, I got to be back in the house of the Lord. This is why Proverbs 22, young people, 22 verse 6 says, train up a child in the way he should go. And when he, that he is generic, which means he or them or that person, when he, as us, as human, mankind, when he is old, he will not depart from it. From what? The training. The discipline. So I understand. I remember, and I don't know about you, the young people, they probably can let you know. I used to hear my mom say, you're working up on a woman. Anybody ever heard that? You're working up on a woman. And the thing about I learned when I was younger, I would say I didn't like all the discipline and the training. But as you get older, I thank God for having a mother that disciplined me. I thank God for having leaders and elders in the church that would discipline me. I thank God for that training. Now I can say that. But when I was going through it, there is no such thing as going through a punishment or being punished where you feel good about it. I've never had a whooping and I was sitting there saying, oh, this feels good. Mama never gave me a whooping, Sister Claire. Well, I was like, yes, this is what I wanted. She was saying, I'm whooping you because I love you. She was saying, you're working upon a whooping. I'm saying, well, why am I working towards that? I don't want that, so let me not work towards that. So I would try to kind of plead and go back and forth with my mother. She said, you're working up. I'm going to get you for old and new. Anybody ever heard that? I would sit there and say, well, then why did we talk about the old things? We should have got that already taken care of before we got to the new things. So let's just back up. And so let's take care of the old things and then we'll get to the new things. So this is how I was. You probably would punish me right now. When I was little, you probably would say, this man, this little boy getting on my nerves. But that's how I was with my mother. I would pretty much go back and forth with her when she would try to talk to me. And so I thank God for the training. I thank God for the teaching. I thank God for those who are in my life, because nobody likes correction, not even us as adults. Nobody likes correction. I don't care how long you've been saved, there will come a point where you will not like the correction. This is why the Bible tells me in 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 16 to 17. Notice what it says. All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine. That cancels out that thing about man wrote that Bible. All scripture is given by inspiration of God. Man could not write if he was not inspired by what God wanted him to write. All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for what? For doctrine. So don't tell me to get off of doctrine. Don't tell me to get off of doctrine. Stop preaching that doctrine. Stop preaching that apostles' doctrine. Y'all talking about apostolic. Get off that doctrine. I cannot. Because why? The word of God or the scriptures is profitable for doctrine. For what? For reproof and for correction. For instruction in righteousness. So when people say, I want to be perfect, this is how it goes. That the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. So if you want to be perfect in the Lord, then you need the word of God. You need the scriptures. And so many times when we were young, I used to think that I knew more than my mother. Anybody else was like that? I used to think I knew no more than my mother. I felt like many times that I could counsel her. I felt like many times I would say, you don't know what you're talking about. I got a lot of hit mouths in there, hits in the lips for saying stuff like that. Yeah. Because I would say certain things. Mama, you don't know what you're talking about. Pop, real quick. I got hit in the mouth when she was talking to other adults, and I felt like I was going to interrupt. And I said, "Mama, I'm ready to go pop real quick." Got a lot of backhands. I think that's why I say my mother's so strong in that right arm, because she would use it real quick and draw it back. Use it real quick and draw it back. And so many times, I remember being in the car. I'm just trying to give you some of these things when I was a child. I remember being in the car, and I thought from the distance, her driving, she couldn't reach me in the back. But while she's driving, there is a quick hand that moves real fast into the back, pop, and comes right back and grabs the wheel. But I'm learning that's what happened when I was a child. And so this is how kids are today. Children are feeling like maybe they know a little bit more than you. They feel like they know more than you. But that's the same way even in the church, people of God. Hear what I'm about to say. That when you get saved, a lot of times you feel like, well, yeah, I heard you, pastor. Or I heard you, man or woman of God. I heard what you're saying, but I just don't get that. I just don't believe that. I saw the scripture. I read the scripture. I get what you said. But you know, you don't really know my understanding. And even after you read the scripture, and after I showed you the scripture, you can still rebuttal and be able to say, well, no, I just don't feel like I need to do all of that. That is the babe in Christ. And sometimes we can be older and feel like we've been in the church for a while, but still be eating or sucking on milk. So there is a lot of still babes in Christ that are not growing up. So let's look at these three points tonight regarding this subject to my young people. Notice what it says. The first point is new babes in Christ. Let's talk about that. Paul, look at what Paul shows us, how new babes in Christ are and their situation or what they're in. Notice what he says to us in the Corinthian church. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verses 1 through 3. Make it simple and you can put it on the monitors. Notice what it says. Dear brothers and sisters, when I was with you, I couldn't talk to you as I would to spiritual people. So when you're dealing with babes in Christ, newborn or newborn believers, you can't really go into a lot of spiritual stuff with them. I had to talk as though you belonged to this world or as though you were infants in Christ. That is how the pastor will deal with the newborn babes in the Lord. I got to deal with you for what you're used to. So a lot of my examples that I will use are the examples that you are dealing with out in that world. But if I try to talk spiritual things to you, some of these things can go over your head and you're going to be like, I don't know what you're talking about. So I use the things that you're dealing with on a natural basis to explain to you what God is wanting from you. So notice what the scripture says. I had to feed you with milk. That's why when somebody say, well, let's get into the deep things of God. I say, no, we don't need to talk about the deep things of God. Let's just get into the simple things of God. And we can talk about the simple things of God. Some people want to go off and be this. You may be saying, well, I feel like God is calling me to the evangelism. I feel like God is wanting me to do this. I feel like God is calling me to this and to do this. I say, well, hold your horses, sit down, and let's learn something first. That's how you have to treat the babes in Christ. I had to feed you with milk. Many times babes in Christ will say, I'm ready to do something for God. I say, that's good. Keep that. But let's learn something first. He says, I had to feed you with milk, not with solid food, because you weren't ready for anything stronger. So there's sometimes some messages. And when the Holy Ghost is talking to me, sometimes what God will say, well, break it down a little bit more. Why? It's because you got many that don't understand. Many may not understand it. And so I'll try to break it down and make it simple as possible. That's why I have visual. I'll show you certain things where you can see visual things that you can understand it. Maybe I'll have some visual, some video, some things to make you understand it simple. Because a lot of people, from what I've learned, like I told you, when I came to the Glade, everybody was real spiritual. Everybody was caught up in the gifts of the spirits and talking about, I got gifts and this and this and that. But when you ask them about the knowledge of the Word of God, they could not explain it or could not bring it down or did not know that that was in the scripture. So what am I come to do? Let's start all the way over and let's break down the word of God so that you can get rooted and grounded in the house of the Lord so that you can know something so now that you can grow. So when you say hallelujah, you know what you're saying. When you say thank you, Jesus, you know what you're saying. When you say I have been changed and I have been made new, when you say that I'm a child of God, then you really understand what it is. When you say I love God, God is my Father, I appreciate all that he has done, you understand why it's important for you to be in the house of the Lord. You understand why it's important for you to get as much scripture and word as possible so that you can grow. And so notice what he says to us. He said, you still aren't ready. That's why sometimes people may say, hey, Pastor, am I ready to do this? I'll explain it to you. No, you're not ready for that yet. For you are still controlled by your sinful nature. So new babes in Christ, many times they're still controlled by their sinful nature. Well, the older, or those who've been walking with God, can understand how to hold their temper. But the new babe in Christ is hard because they're still close to that sinful nature to pop off and it can go off. But as you get older, you begin to say, you know what? Go ahead, I'll humble myself. And you go ahead and do it. Do it and go ahead and have it. And you'll be able to keep your mouth closed and agree quickly with your adversary. That's how it goes. But notice what it says, for you are still controlled by your sinful nature. Notice what happens in your sinful nature. You are jealous of one another. That's why many saints that are babes in Christ, they have not grown. Because in church, you can get jealous over one another. When you see a child or a babe in Christ being jealous because this person is positioned, or they're crawling back and forth, or they're saying this, or they're saying this, or they're upset, and why is this doing this, and why is doing this, and you got something to say about this, you got something to say about that, that lets you know that there are a babe in Christ. Because they're still bickering over small little things. For you are still controlled by your sinful nature. You are jealous of one another, quarreling with each other. Doesn't that prove you are controlled by your sinful nature? That is a question. Are you living like the people of the world? He's asking that question. But move to Hebrews chapter 5, verse 12 to 14. Notice what the Bible says. I'm giving you this scripture so that you can understand it. Look at the NLT as well. Make it simple. You have been believers so long now that you ought to be teaching others. So just because people are in church and just because they've been going to church for a long time, don't mean that they're full grown or mature in the Lord. Some of them still are child or children or babes in Christ. Instead, you need someone to teach you again the basic things about God's word. You are like babies who need milk and cannot eat solid food. But someone who lives on milk is still an infant and doesn't know how to do what is right. That's why you always are around your children. No mother or father will leave their newborn baby, or they shouldn't leave their children, those kids that are underage, at home by themselves. Why? Because they can hurt themselves. So with that being said, you want to know why the mom, or why pastor, or why the leader may try to stay close to you, call you, text you, maybe try to talk to you, try to minister to you, want to check on you, want to see how you're doing. Why? Because I don't want you to hurt yourself spiritually. So I'm going to stay around you. I'm going to counsel you. I'm going to talk to you, spend some time with you. I know you may not like it. I didn't like the correction. I didn't like my mother looking over me, over my shoulder, and always trying to check on me. But what was she trying to do? Keep me out of some things. And for that reason, now I can hug her neck and say, Mom, I thank you for being a good mother. I thank you for praying for me. I thank you for being there. Because I see my friends. I see them. See, many of them had babies way before they ever got out of high school. I see some of the diseases that they were caught up in. I see some of the things. Some of them are not even here today because they had nobody really to love them. At the time, I was hating you. At the time, I talked back to you. At the time, I didn't want to be around you. At the time, I wanted to leave your house. But I thank God that you stayed on top of me, that my soul is still in the house of the Lord today. Come on, somebody. To the mature saints, don't give up on the babes in Hallelujah. They cannot eat the milk right now. Drink them. They only can drink the milk. They cannot eat the solid food. For someone who lives on milk is still an infant, doesn't know how to do what is right. Solid food is for those who are mature, who through training have the skill to recognize the difference between right and what else? And wrong. So when you find yourself being mature, this is how you can kind of set it up and be able to see if you're growing, Sister K. This is how you're able to do that. That when you start checking and some things, think about some things that you used to do that you are not doing. That's how you can check and say, you know what, I'm kind of growing. Because in back in the day, I would have went off on it. But today, I just want to say, bless you. This is how you know that you're growing. That back in the day, I would have skipped church. But now, I'm in the house of the Lord more than I've ever been in the house of the Lord. This is how that goes. And even when you start seeing certain things, I don't hang with them like that no more. I actually don't go out with them like that no more. I actually don't watch that like that. I used to watch that no more. I don't know what's happening. There's a change happening with you. You're now growing. And this is how God wants to see the people of God in the house of the Lord growing. Because if you're not growing, then there's a problem. Could you imagine sin? I could not imagine sin, my son, my oldest son, if he was still acting like my daughter at the age of 2. I would say, Doc, something is wrong with my son. Doc, he's still using the restroom on himself. Doc, he's doing this and doing that. Something is wrong. So that is how we look at it today. When you're not growing spiritually, what am I saying? Doc, Lord, the great physician, something is wrong with this one. Something is wrong with this one. Because they should know some things. They should know these things. They should know not to do these things. Something is wrong. But with the new babes in Christ, I understand. I got to give a leeway for them to be able to continue to grow and love them and to correct them and lead them in the right direction. So that's why, saints, to the older saints, you might see me a lot of times dealing or talking to the new converts. Do not get me feeling like, hey, man, he don't feel like he want to have time to deal with her. I still love you, too. You hear what I said? Saints, the older saints, I still love you, too. But I got to spend as much time as I can with the new babes in Christ to get them up to par. So what am I saying? Just like mama would say that us in the house of your older brothers, watch out for the young ones. This is how we grow in the house of the Lord. So the new babes in Christ, I got to spend much time with them, but I have not forgotten about you either. Amen. In 1 Peter chapter 2 verses 1 through 2. Wherefore, laying aside all malice and all guile and hypocrisy and envies and all evil speaking. Notice verses 2. As newborn babes, desire the sincere milk of the word, that ye may grow thereby. So new babes in Christ will deal with hypocrisy. New babes in Christ, you'll see them loving God one day, and then all of a sudden you'll see them doing this one day. New babes in Christ, you'll see them doing this or acting like this, but then one day you'll see them lifting up their hands, crying out, repenting. These are new babes in Christ. So that's why I say, when I was a child, I remember, I never forget how I was when I was a child. Because when I was a child, I know what the struggle that you guys deal with. Because I was there as well. And any adult that's been saved for a while should never forget how they were when they were a child. Look at how you were when you were a child and what you used to do and how much mercy you needed. I'm not trying to tell you to let them get away with murder. I'm not trying to tell you to let them do these things or do this or do that. I'm not trying to say to you to allow them to run your house and talk back and do all of this. Still use the hand like my mama used to use. But at the same time, I'm saying be merciful for them and help them to grow. Amen? Amen. And so notice what Matthew 19 verse 13 to 15 says. Then were they brought unto him little children, that he should put his hands on them and pray. And the disciples rebuked them. Notice what they were doing. They were trying to bring the children unto Jesus. They were trying to get the little babes unto Jesus. But the disciples said, no, get away from him. No, stay away from him. And notice what Jesus did. He rebuked the disciples or the followers or the ones that were with him. Notice what happens. He said, but Jesus said, suffer the little children and forbid them not to come unto me, for of such is the kingdom of heaven. And he laid his hands upon them and departed thence. So what am I telling you? Do not keep your children out of church. Do not keep your children from the Lord. Do not keep your children from doing what is right and teaching them, because they are babes, they are children, and they need more Jesus now than they ever needed before. So parents, I need your help to raise your own children. Teach them what the Bible says and be an example to them. If you want them to be people of God or people of God, you got to be the people of God. Come on with that. I want my daughter to know how a man is supposed to treat her. Let me show her by how I treat my wife. And so this is how you do it to your sons. You show them and you make them respect. But before all of that, I want them to know the God that I serve. I serve the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. That is now my God as well. And I want him to be your God as well. Which leads me to my second point, growing in the Lord. So babes in Christ, we all must grow in the Lord. But there will come a time when God will say, change the way you see yourself. You cannot be babes forever. Children and children forever. There comes a time when you might see me, and I say, sis, I'm expecting a little bit more out of you now. My brother, I'm expecting a little bit more. Teens, I know you teach, I know you get taught over there in over the teen class. Teens, I know you're learning some things. I know Sister Porter, I know Minister Shepherd, they taught you some things. I know that they've been there with you. I know you answered some scripture. I know you've been coming to Bible study for quite some time now. I know you read it on the scripture, because we went over it a whole bunch of times. If you can hear, remember me saying, rock on with your bad self. If you can hear, remember me saying, we ain't doing that no way, then I understand that you can remember what the scriptures are saying. So there's going to come a time when I'm going to say to you, no, you cannot continue to look at yourself as a babe in Christ. You got to look at yourself and be able to say, you know what, I'm growing up a little bit older now, and there's some things that God has required of me, Sister Tennessee, that I need to do now. And so this is why Jeremiah, notice what the scripture says in Jeremiah chapter 1 verse 5 to 7. Notice what he said to them. Before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before thou camest forth out of thy mother womb, I sanctified thee. God says, I already know what I was making you to be. And I ordained thee. Notice, before you ever knew that you who you were, I ordained you, or I chose this one, to be a prophet unto the nations. And verse 6 says, then said I. Notice what the child says. Then say I, Lord God, behold, I cannot speak, for I am a child. And many of us walking around saying, no, Pastor, I ain't ready for that, because I'm still a child. No, 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 it's time to grow up. No, 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 you got to put that milk away. No, 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 I understand I may have to cut it down a little bit, but you got to eat this meat. This is what will give you strength. That milk, you're going to be hungry in a few hours. But I got to give you something more, sis. That's why I tell Sister Porter now, you got to give them a little bit of meat. You got to give them a little bit more. You got to train them a little bit harder. You got to tell them what they got to do and what they cannot do. You got to say, no, I ain't your friend. I'm your mother and your father. And you got to get right. You can't keep doing this. Don't keep bringing these bad grades. Talking about, I'm trying. No, we got to do a little bit better than that. We ain't coming in here with no more C's. We got to step up and get to the B's and the A's. We got to step up and be better. We got to do a little bit greater. Come on, people of God, let's do a little bit better. We are no longer babes, but you got to grow up. see yourself as that little child. He said, then said I, Lord, oh Lord God, behold, I cannot speak, for I am a child. Notice what the scripture says. But the Lord said unto me, say not, I am a child. I need you to talk a little bit different now. See yourself a little bit different now. Notice what he says. For thou shalt go to all that I shall send thee, and whatsoever I command thee, thou shalt speak. The child said, I cannot do it. He says, you're going to do it. And do not say that I'm a child, that I can't do it. So many times we get into that place where we come into the 2 years. And so I'm looking for more leaders to take position and take their role. Why? Because the church has to grow. So I'm asking you and I'm accounting on you. And I'm wanting you to grow up so that you can be in certain positions. But I got to be able to trust you, my son. I got to be able to trust you, my daughter. I got to be able to trust you, brother. Got to be able to trust you, my sister. I got to be able to put you in position and in places that you will be consistent and always in position. Not looking and saying, man, I thought they were a little bit more mature now. Man, maybe I can't put them in certain leadership because they don't know how to deal with people. They don't know how to do this. They give up real easy. They walk away real easy. I don't got time for that. I need you to grow up. I need you to do what you got to do. When it's time for prayer, I need you to be in prayer. When it's time to be in prayer, you got to be back there praying before you sleep. You got to be doing this before you do that. You got to wake up and get into prayer. You got to be in Bible study. You got to know the word of God. You got to surrender your life. You got to be able to speak the word of God. And how can you speak it if you don't know it? So what is that, Lord? I need you to grow up and don't say that I'm a child. But look at what God wants you to be the prophet of the nation. To speak that which I've given to you. And so I thank God for that. And so one of the youngest kings, young people, listen to this right here. Sometimes you might say, well, I'm young. Listen to what I'm saying, young man. Sometimes you might say, I'm young. Says the great, you might say that I'm young, says the Tavy. You might say that I'm young. I don't really know, Brother Anthony. I don't even know. I don't know if I can do that. I don't know. I don't know, sis. I don't know if I can really do that, sister. But I don't know. This is what you might say. But God can use anyone at any age. He can use anyone at any age. Anyone. That's why I tell the saints or the parents, do not hold your children back when they mention to you, you know what, Mom? I want to get baptized. Mom, Pastor has been preaching about baptism in Jesus' name. I want to do that. Now, if you want to ask them, what does it mean? They're going to explain it to you in a childlike way. Not in a mature way like you can explain it. But they're hearing. Notice what it says. Faith cometh by hearing. Hearing by the word of God. So the young people are learning. Pastor, that is how my youngest said. Daddy, you said that I got to be baptized in Jesus' name for me to be saved at the age of 6. You said that, Daddy. And so if I'm not baptized, then that means I cannot go to heaven. When he mentioned that to me, he can break down the scripture to me, but he began to let me know, you said, and if you're the preacher and the preacher that said, I can't go to heaven without baptism, why won't you baptize me? When he said that to me, I said, you know what, son? You're going to get your sins washed away. Because I cannot hold that from you. And I went on from that to explain a little bit more. This is how your children can grow. When you as parents explain it to them. Right. When they come to church, they're just getting a little bit of what you've already told them. But if there's no teaching at the home, then all of the teaching has to go forth within about an hour. That's all I get with you is about an hour of teaching. That's all. And it's not fair, but I got to do what I got to do. Because you live in this world and you're not in church. You're in church. You're outside of church more than you are in church. So I only got a little hour to explain or talk to you. And so Josiah became king of Judah at the age of 8. I don't know if you know that. Could you imagine being a king at the age of 8? 8 years old, you're the king. 8 years old, you're the one giving counsel. Now, I don't know anybody in here that would vote for a president and they're at the age of 8 years old. I don't know what rules they'll make up. Could you imagine your 8-year-old making up rules for the United States of America? You talking about in trouble. Lord, we'll all be praying. Even the sinners will be praying, Lord God, help them, Lord Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Whatever your name is, Lord, I just want you to help them. Could you imagine that? 8 years old, and you're the king. So God can use anybody at whatever age. But when he calls you, it's time to grow up. It's time to stop doing the same things that you've always done. And then coming back saying, well, I'm still entangled with this. No, it's time to grow up. And so Paul teaches this lesson to us, that many will look at you and see you as a child. Many may look at me and say, that man is young. Many may look at you and say this, but there's a lot of wisdom from the word of God. Not my wisdom, but as much as if I can get God's word, then I get more wisdom. That when they talk to me, just like Jesus did when he was at the age of 12 and his mother was looking for him and they were speaking at the temple, they were looking at Jesus saying, wait a minute, how this child, paraphrasing for you, how this child got all of this wisdom? And when mom called him, he said, Mama, did you not know I was about my father's business? What was he doing? He had the word of God on him at the young age of 12. And so what am I telling you? The more word that you can get on the inside, the more wisdom or the more adult that you can be in the Lord. So you don't have to be a babe or an infant, but if you can get more of the word of God on the inside of you, and then you can develop some wisdom and some growth, and then you won't continue to do the same things that you've done. This is what the question is. This is what happens. Notice what 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 12. We're getting ready to get out of here. Let no man despise thy youth, but be thou an example of the believers in word, in conversation, in charity or love, in spirit and in faith, in purity. Notice what Paul is telling the young preacher, Timothy. Timothy dealt with a lot of people that looked at him a certain way. This old little preacher over here. But Paul was encouraging, saying, no, 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 you show them. That's why I tell the young people, if mama don't want to be saved, you show her. Mama, this is what it means to be apostolic. Mama, this is what it means to be a Christian. Daddy, this is what it means to be a man of God at a young age. Mama, we need to be at church. What are you doing? You getting ready? Okay, I'm just letting you know I'm already ready. You can show your family, your mom, your dads, without disrespecting, Mama, we're supposed to be saved. Why are you listening to that? Mom, why are you watching that? Mom, Dad, why are you letting that in the house like that? And why are you letting them do that? I thought we were saved. Are we not saved? You at a young age could be an example. You can tell mom, Mom, I don't want to put that on. Daddy, I don't want to wear that now. I got the Holy Ghost. I actually sing in the pulpit. So if I'm singing in the pulpit, then why later are you trying to tell me this is okay to wear? You can let your own parents know, no, we shouldn't be doing that. You can be a witness to your own parents. And you're not being disrespectful because you are wanting to live right and do what's right. You're just saying, Mama, I'm not playing with God. You can play with God, but I'm not playing with God. I love God. He gave me the Holy Ghost. I see you at the altar crying and weeping. I see you doing this, and I see you doing that. And so because I was doing that, God talked to me. God deals with me. And so because of that, I don't want to lose my relationship with God. So Mama, rock on with your bad self. If you want to do that, do what you got to do. But I'm going to believe in God. I'm going to be the one that is in the house to continue to live for God. So I want this house to be blessed. And if you're not going to bring the blessings here, then God, look at me. Bless this house because I'm still here. Notice what he says to remember. Verses 14, look at what it says. Do not neglect the spiritual gift you received through the prophecy spoken over you when the elders of the church laid their hands on you. I remember the first day I heard my mother say to me, we're getting ready to close and get out of here. I remember what my mother said to me, and I took it as a joke. She said this to me, and I felt like she was saying it in the fly. Oh, did I say it? No, she's saying it in the fly. She was talking. She said, son, you got that name for a reason. Bishop Garment, Bishop Otis C. Garment, named after him. I'm oldest seed garment a second. She said, you got that name for a reason. I wasn't thinking about no granddaddy. You got that name for a reason. Every time Bishop would come on, my granddaddy, he was a bishop at Zion Temple. He was a bishop back in Gary. And every time he spoke, the first words that came out of his mouth was one Lord, one faith, one baptism. Every time he opened his mouth, before he was there, they used to do broadcasting about 1 o'clock in the morning. You hear Bishop Otis C. Garvin said, one Lord, one faith, one baptism. And so here I am today talking about the same thing. One Lord, one faith, one baptism. I'm saying the same thing. And my mother began to say it. I had preachers prophesy over me. I had people pray over me and say, Lord, this is the one that is yours. This is the one that you have. And they begin to lay their hands on me. So what is Paul letting us know? Don't forget the time that you was prophesied over when they laid their hands on you. When Bishop laid his hands on you and said, you're going to do a mighty work. I just thought it was what it was. But now I'm standing in the place that was prophesied over me to be able to win souls and to teach people what to the word of God. I didn't understand why they were inviting me to come to Bible study. I didn't understand why they were telling me to do this. But now I know, God, it came to life and I'm in the place. I'm not saying I'm a child, but whatever you want to do, use it in me, God, and help me to help somebody else. So my last is this. Learning to put away childish things. So 1 Corinthians, our scripture text says, chapter 13, verse 11, when I was a child, I spake as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, what did you do? I put away childish things. But now we see through a glass darkly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then shall I know even as also I am known. And so what God has let me know to be confident. Be confident in the place. Be confident in the place and where I am right now. Be confident. Even Peter said in 2 Peter chapter 3 verse 18. I've got to give you these scriptures. But grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To him be glory both now and forever. Amen. You might say, Pastor, how did you get to that point? I had to get a hunger and thirst for the word of God. How did you get the wisdom? How did you stop doing some of the things that you were able to get out of? I had to get a hunger. So that means I had to develop a hunger for the word. And the only way that you can develop a hunger for the word is be around the word. The more word you get, the more it becomes good to you. It may be bitter in the beginning, but the more you chew on it and you digest it, you begin to say, man, that was real, real good. I never heard it like that. That did something to my bones. That talked to me today. That gave me some tears that rolled down my eyes. And I begin to learn and open up and begin to say, you know what, man? It'll make you actually open up the Bible and study yourself to make you say, you know what? Let me read that again. Man, I never heard it like that. This is how you are able to grow when you get a hunger and thirst for the word of God. Let us stand. This is all when I was a child. And so I want you to look at yourself. I want you to look at yourself. Are you still in that babe area? Are you still in that babe area? A baby, you got to continue, or a child, you got to continue to tell them, stop doing this, stop doing that, when they know better or when they just want to just do what they want to do. But an adult, you can let them know and they say, I'm sorry. And they move on. And we are not all babes in Christ. I understand some are. But some of us need to answer that call to grow and mature in the Lord. Amen. We're going to a second year, people of God. I keep mentioning this. And God is calling many of you to take your places and positions. But if you stay in that place as a babe in Christ, then he cannot use you in the kingdom of God right now. And your time can pass you by. So if you're here tonight, if you've never been baptized, if you've never repented and baptized in the name of Jesus, come on and join the house of the kingdom of God. We ask that you will look at yourself and ask yourself, have you been where you needed to be? Because God is calling you today. And I know many times people will say, "Hey, Pastor, pray for me." Because you might be struggling over the same things over and over again. And those struggles come, as I told you before this morning, your struggles come because you have not totally surrendered to the Lord. So anytime you are struggling as a saint, it's because you have not totally surrendered. When things are still struggling for you and you're like, "Man, I got to do a little bit better and I'm doing this and doing this," it's because you have not totally surrendered. You're fighting this salvation thing. You're fighting against God. So if you stop fighting against God, it becomes easier for you. Surrender. Surrender. Let them go. Stop doing this. Stop going there. Stop watching this. Stop doing these things that put things in your mind that is struggles. Around the wrong people that put thoughts in your mind. Friends that you need to disconnect from. I'm telling you, if you want to be saved, surrender. Surrender. Stop struggling with this thing. Surrender. Surrender. Surrender unto God. So come on and get baptized. In the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of your sins, and God will fill you with the gift of the Holy Ghost. We love you, and we know that God loves you more. Let us lift up our hands unto the Lord. If you're here, we ask that God to touch your heart to come. Join us as we are in the kingdom of God. Father God, we love you right now. We thank you, Lord God, for those who have come to this altar, the young people. I pray that more youth, Lord God, will get involved in the kingdom of God. I pray that you will deal with them, Lord God, and help them, Lord God, and show them like you did Jeremiah the prophet. I pray in the name of Jesus, even for those who, Lord God, are older, oh God, that you will begin to deal with their hearts and mind as well, to begin to grow, Lord God, and not be the same way that they were last year, or Lord God, even months from now. But we all want to grow, Lord God. So I want to surrender, oh God. Let us surrender unto you. Let us give ourselves away. Let us let go of the world, Lord God. Let us let the old be the old, but all things now have become new. We give you glory, honor right now. Forgive us for what we have done. Forgive us for our ways, oh God. Let me not, Lord God, do these things that I should not do. Let me be in the house of the Lord. Let me be a part of praise and worship. Let me lift up my hands, oh God. Let me not get bored in church. Let me not, Lord God, get tired of this, because this is what I need. Not every message, oh God, is going to amuse me, but some messages are going to be there to speak right to me, and I got to hear it to grow. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus, let me surrender to truth. If I'm not in truth, let me come out of a false church to get the word of God that I need. Let me change my life. But only you can do it, God. If I want to be saved, you created the way for me to be saved. I just must yield to the word of God. So if you're here tonight, Father, I pray, touch their heart, trouble the waters of baptism. Don't let them leave here, oh God. Lord, trouble them before they walk out the doors, to let them know they cannot continue in that way. They got to get baptized. They got to be filled with the Holy Ghost. They got to repent, God. There's no need to continue to go to church and act like you're saved, but repent and get right and stay right, so that God can use you and so that you can be saved in the kingdom of God. We remember all that you have done, and I remember when I was a child. Thank you, Lord, for allowing me to grow. We give you glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' mighty name, we all say amen, amen. God bless you. We love you. We give God praise for you. We'll continue to pray for you. We want to welcome you again to the new life. Welcome your brother, your sister. Shake their hand. Let them know you're glad to see them. Don't just leave out without coming. Give somebody a handshake or a hug. We give God the glory and honor for you in Jesus' name. God bless you. We'll be here in the house of the Lord on Monday. Come on back on Monday night and get the word of God. Let's invite somebody to the house of the Lord. God bless you. God bless you. We love you, but we know God loves you more in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.